local high school doing demos for the company. So I decided I'll make a video while I wait because I'm kind of the photographer for today. So it's pretty sweet. It's going well. These schools are really interesting. Let me show you around. Dude, these schools are epic. They're so big. And they're always in the shape of either an L or a U with a huge courtyard in the middle. And it's to promote like gatherings. So it's pretty neat. It's really nice for the kids. They can hang out with their friends and stuff. The only problem is it's really hot and they're still not cranking the AC. It must get really hot before they actually turn the air conditioners on. But I'll tell you what, I'm impressed. The schools are nice, but I remember I said in an older video how it's normal to like always be patient and expect the worst here. Well, our entire program is run, we need Wi-Fi, screen, our tablets and all that. So because of that, it's really been like messy today, but we finally salvaged everything. So, you know, it's one of those things you really learn here is like oftentimes you'll actually have the worst happen in Vietnam and you really learn to deal with it. Like I can imagine coming back home, like other things, like it's not gonna be an issue compared to like the issues you deal with here. So, A-okay, man, I'm digging it. So anyways, let's go see what the teachers have done.
Yo, what a day. When was the last time we spoke? I was kind of telling you that things weren't going so well because it wasn't really planned out well. I decided at that point that probably the title of this video is going to be something like, what a disaster. Because today was kind of a disaster. But it was a disaster in like a Western sense of like just a lack of planning. But it wasn't like terrible or like the end of the world like we would think back at home. By Vietnamese standard, it was pretty normal. Like basically like the way our system works is we have to be linked into a router, and then that router is connected to the, or the Chromecast in the TV is connected to the router, and then we're connected to the router, so then we can Chromecast onto the TV, right?
Okay.
Now, the problem became that our IT guy checked one TV, and it worked fine, and they said, oh, every other TV is the same.
Oh, okay.
And you know, with IT, there's always stuff that's gonna go wrong, so of course, that's what happened today. Things went wrong. What kind of bugged me was like, basically, like, we ended up, like, you know, like, teachers were, like, freaking out. But it's just weird because, like, for me, again, you get used to it. And basically, the point of this is not to complain, but it's to kind of tell you guys when you come here, like, expect the unexpected. Like, if you want that stable job where you come in, you teach, and you go home, go to a different country. Your boss is most likely going to ask of that for you. I can tell you a story when her and me worked together where, like, our old boss was like, call parents. I want to do a parents meeting. Except she didn't tell us. Luckily, because I was with her, I found out. And then like 2 or 3 days before the parents came, we got a letter from our boss saying like, hey, parents are coming. And I was like, what? Like, we weren't ready for that. It was a complete disaster. We're used to that, you know, like in Vietnam really like makes or breaks you. Like, you know, you see like, are you a diamond under pressure or are you gonna crack? Something to really, really think about. You will be put in awkward situations. You will be thrown into classrooms with 50 students and been like, all right, go teach them. And you're like, teach them what? You gotta figure it out. You know, it's the challenge and like that spontaneous creativity. For us, we're used to working with like the fanciest technology, you know, we're on these tablets and blah blah blah, but you can see like some people are so used to it that as soon as they lose it, they have no idea what to do. And for me, it was just fascinating, you know, like fascinating in a kind of like masochistic way of like watching people suffer. She can tell you like,
because it's... for Vietnamese, we don't care. Something happened, we fake that, we try to like work with that. But like after like almost 2 years working with foreigners, I realized like foreigners need everything to plan. So if like you want have the meeting with a parent, you should tell them at least like a week, two weeks before that meeting, so they won't be freaked out or like upset or like prepare, get preparation for that. Just for Vietnamese, we say, okay, we do that, we do this, like right after like the boss tell you. But with foreigners, there's a lot of them like cannot handle that stress.
Yeah, it really will like grind you down over time if you're that kind of person. I thought I was actually a weak person until I came here. I really didn't think I'd be able to handle it, but I don't know, so far, like, I don't know, I think I've been pretty all right. Even after today, like, I wasn't really freaking out. I was pretty calm. Like, my boss called me and, like, apologized for the disaster. She's, like I told you over and over, she's very kind.
Because sometimes, like, if you have, like, kind of, like, the boss, like, the old boss we have, like, when she, like, just...
She was a maniac.
Yeah, we tell you, like, do things, like, what she want to done now. Like, you have to do that, even you don't want. And that, like, you know that wouldn't turn out like the disaster.
Yeah.
But I think after, like, if you can work with her, that kind of boss, I think you wouldn't be fine with everything.
Would you mean the crazy boss?
Mm.
I mean, if you do exactly what you're told, but, you know, I maybe I kind of spoiled her because, like, she's having problems now at work as well because she speaks her mind too much. It's not appreciated in the workplace here, but that's a different story for another time. Anyways, yeah, like, it was, like I said, it was a disaster today, but it was okay. It was a learning experience, and, like, it's something that, like, I took away from it. Like, you know, kind of just smile and make the most of it. Like, whatever. We're getting paid. We're scheduled for it. Do it, you know. Just please, whatever you do, if you sign up and you're stressed out, just, like, try to grit your teeth and do it. Don't walk away. It looks really bad. Otherwise, my team did well. We handled it pretty all right. But, yeah, some people were, like, freaking out, like, that haven't been here that long. And I was like...
My team did well, too.
It's all kinds of, like, funky. No planning here. Just do. I'm actually doing the same thing, I realized. Like, her and me, like, we're looking. We are gonna end up moving, by the way. We're still looking for, like, a really nice place. But, like, it's funny, she's like, oh yeah, like, I think we'll go look at a place maybe tomorrow morning. So very likely we'll just wake up in the morning, call, and be like, all right, let's go. Like, we called a real estate agent the one time at like 8 o'clock at night, and she's like, all right, come meet me. And, like, she met us, and we're like, what, like, really, you're still working? All right, like, so it was great. Anyways, yeah, Vietnam's great for you as a customer because the last minute things, like, people will actually do for you. But working here, you have to deal with that last minuteness. You won't see that in Korea or Taiwan or Japan, I don't think. But here, like, it's absolutely normal that, like, things happen at the drop of a hat, and you just got to deal with it. And especially for me, like, in a managerial role, you got to be prepared because you're working directly with the Vietnamese staff. So, you know, it's important for you to learn, like, who can and who can handle it. And then the people who really have trouble with it, keep them doing other things in the office that are more comfortable. And then the people who are outgoing, like, get them out in the field and doing that, you know?
You should expect that when you're working with the Vietnamese staff. Don't never, like, assume everything wouldn't be fine, everything wouldn't be perfect. You always need to, like, create the plan B. Like, you're ready for the best situation.
Because I've used plan B a lot. A lot more than I'm proud to say, but... Yeah,
it's good. Really, he's good at that. I learned a lot from him, like, when, like, he tried, like, make everything going well.
Yeah, people were laughing at me last night before this, and I was like, it's gonna be a disaster, and everybody was like, dude, calm down, don't be such a pessimist. And then it happened, and everybody's like, oh my god, and I was like, I told you. And they're like, oh, that's why you don't freak out. I was like, exactly, just breathe, you know. Like, you know, remember, if you're a soldier and your life's on the line, then, you know, you can freak out. But your life's never on the line. You know, worst thing you're gonna have is a bad day, and so be it. You know, so. Yeah, Vietnam. Thanks for watching, guys. That was a weird one today. I thought it was gonna be much more exciting, but yeah. Catch you in the next one. It's time for bed.
Yep. Bye.
Back to the school again. It's early morning though, not afternoon. Kids are hopefully calmer, and I hope it's not such a big disaster today. So we'll see. I'm gonna see if they want to make any videos with me. Maybe it should be fun. So see how it goes, and hopefully I can wake up a bit too.
Yo, what up, guys? I realized I never made an end to this video. It's been like a day since we did this event, so
I did want to say, second day was much better. Everything was excellent. So we're all done. The school, as usual, to add on to it, we had a schedule and they decided, like, they're like, oh, can you change your schedule last minute and do blah, blah, blah. And we were like, no, we're just not going to come back. Thank you. Basically, yeah. Otherwise, yeah, we can't work on their schedule. Like I said earlier in the video, it's very, very much like last minute here. So, you know, I thought we'd end it there. And keep your eyes open. We are actually moving. As you can see, we're packing. We got people coming tomorrow to pick stuff up and move it for us. So that is the next video. So we're going to have a nice new 3-bedroom apartment, which is way too big for 2 people. But we'll find something to do with the space. I might actually be able to have a proper, like, actual studio where I can actually put up my green screen and, you know, and have, like, a space for, like, my big fancy light, you know, and, you know, nice place to edit. And I really want to play more video games, and I want to have better internet so that I can actually live stream me playing video games, because I love watching people live streaming video games. So we can have some video games and vlogs, so you can learn about me outside of, you know, in Vietnam, and you can learn about me, like, and my gaming stuff, because I miss playing video games, and my PlayStation's so sad, just sitting there so lonely. And there's new updates for Assassin's Creed that I want to play, and Borderlands 3 is coming out in a few months, and there's so much going on, I just want to do it all. So, anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye!